Second class will be all about dark elves. Now, obviously, it's still going to be connected to the first class because we're still going to be talking a little bit about the deep roads. Now, why would that be? Why would there be a direct connection between the deep roads and the Dok'Alfar? Okay. Jalil Katamari, go ahead. That's all true. The deep roads were once the Drow Empire. At one time, there was a vast empire under Terra that was the Dark Elven Empire. Many, many moons ago, when the elves first arrived on Terra, it was only dragons. There were no other races here. It was a primal planet with lava and ash and natural forces being the only things there. The only intelligent life form were dragons. Now, when the elves arrived, it was extremely dangerous to survive. Okay? In its natural state, elves were too fragile to survive. So, the bands that came over, split up. Each band chose a different force to model themselves after so that they could survive. One of the bands, they had brought animals with them. And they decided that animals were how they would survive. Whether it be wolves, bats, dolphins, birds, whatever it happened to be, and that was the beginning of wild elves. One of the bands decided to make huge fortified cities against the world, and that is how they would survive. And that would be the high elves. Another band decided that the forests were the right answer, and they became the wood elves. Another band decided that darkness would be how they would survive, and they became the dark elves. They went deep into the earth, over 500,000 years ago, and began their own society. And at a around 500,000 years ago, which they had been there a significant amount of time before that, but about around 500,000 years ago, the forces of chaos discovered Terra. The exact amount of time that the Dok'Alfar Empire had been in place by that time is debatable. But one of the Dok'Alfar deities, sometimes referred to as Loth, other times referred to as Loth, sometimes referred to as the Spider Queen, was in love with one of the fellow deities, the leader of the elves, the leader of the Seldarine, sometimes referred to as Corellon Larathion. But her level of power wasn't near his. So when he chose a wife, it wasn't her. She was not happy about that. She figured that if she had more power, then, she could become his wife. So she sought out ancient demons before the Tanari were even conceived of. These demons were called the Oberynth. They were disembodied forces. When they did appear, it was a tangle of eyes and mouths and teeth and tentacles. So she sought them out. And they discovered Terra through her. She promised them power. She promised them that she would allow them to have access to the plane of law, to have access to physicality, gravity, inertia, strength, in return for power. And they granted it to her. And they made Loth considerably more powerful. She became a greater god at that point. And she thought that that would give her the ability to become Corellon Larathion's mate. However, when you deal with demons, there's always a price, right? And the price in this case was that when they came, they wanted it all. She opened the door, and they decided they weren't going to just take the little bit that she offered. They were going to take all of it. And so they attacked. And since they didn't like the light, they had spent all this millennia in the dark. So they went straight for her empire, which was vast by this time. And went straight for the Dark Elves. and they fought back. They did not want to become nothingness. They rebelled. Right? And they fought back. And the Dok'Alfar had magic. Well, Forces of Chaos didn't understand what that was. Okay? What is magic? So, the first attack by the Forces of Chaos, they got their tails handed to them. Okay? But they already have their foot in the door, right? So over time, they decided to make a second assault. Now this time, there were a few other races down there. The Kuwatoa were born. The Sahagin were born. There were now deep dragons. There were now deep worms. Owlbears. Hookhorrors. And the Illithid had brought forth beings such as Grell. And Zorns. So they were building their own little nest in the Underdark now. Okay? In the Deep Roads. So, and they had massive amounts of mind control ability. So all these beings around them, they controlled to attack the Dok'Alfar. But they lost again. It was more costly this time for the Dok'Alfar. But it was all right. Well, the Mind Flayers, the Illithid, had a deeper hold now. Now they had actually carved a niche into the Deep Roads and started breeding their own beasties and starting becoming a force to be reckoned with. And now comes along the Svirfneblin, which are the deep gnomes, and the Dugar, which are the deep dwarves. And Mindflayers are really, really smart, right? They also began learning magic. So over the course of the next couple hundred thousand years, carving out their niche in the Deep Roads, they also began mind controlling Svirfneblin and Dugar to create another race of constructs called the Metallici. In time, they began the next Spider-Squid Wars. The second Spider-Squid Wars. The official second Spider-Squid Wars. And this time, they had foot soldiers. Not only were they mind-controlling the local beasties, okay, but they also had their own soldiers that had been crafted by the combined mind slaves of the Svirfneblin and the Dugar. When you put dwarves and gnomes together, you get some pretty powerful stuff. They don't normally work together so very well. But under mind slave, they kind of don't have a choice, right? And they came up with the Metallici. And they almost completely wiped out the Dark Elves. And as one would might guess, Corellon Lirathian was not so very happy with Loth. So she did not get him as her mate, did she? No. No. So all of this stuff that she had done to try to get him as her mate kind of backfired. She took many mates in the interim, but she always ate her children, because she knew that there is a prophecy, and there has always been a prophecy, that your child will replace you. So she made sure that would never happen. And you can't kill gods unless you eat them. If you devour them whole, they can still come back, because they're just hanging out in your stomach, because they don't die. You have to chop them up in little bit pieces and separate those pieces. So she always ate her children. One day, Corellon came to her and took her as a mate for one night. Happy as a clam she was. And did not immediately eat her children when they were born. Well, when she went to him and said, "Hey, you got some kids, you know?" He said, "No, I don't. I don't know what you're talking about. I never slept with you." She was mad. But by that time, her children were gone. They were stolen. But she was really, really mad. And she continued to do as she always had. In fact, around this time, she discovered a dark elf who was very full of hate, similar to the Metallici. And she made him her boy toy, turned him into a god. But he hated her more than he did anyone else, because he blamed her for everything that was going on. Right? So you know, he did not get over the fact that it was her fault in his mind that the Dark Elf race was almost gone. It was her fault. Stupid, I'm gonna kill you. And so, you know, one day he tried. Well, he's a demigod. She's a greater god. She turned him inside out. He died. No more. No more god of hate at that point. He's back now, so I guess it doesn't matter. But, you know, it does tell you a little bit about the Spider Queen. You know, the prophecy did catch up with her. her children did kill her and eat her and replace her. So, you know, hey, prophecy's always going to get you. Yes, Red Master. Oh yes, it would take me a long time to tell you the details, but she definitely, yeah, she didn't go easy on him. You know, I mean, she turned him inside out ultimately, but that doesn't necessarily mean that that was it. Because if you're very good, you can turn someone out inside out and then they'll still live. Until you're done with him. But she did not go easy on him at all. Okay, but she was killed and replaced. So there is a new Loth. She's still Loth, but it's not the same one anymore. Because you cannot actually destroy that kind of power. It has to be passed on. And so it was. Now, let's move on to other things. That kind of sets a stage. I know that one of the biggest things that in D&D that people might like about Dark Elves is the fact that they're 90% resistant to magic. Obviously, in SL, we really can't, you know, do that. It's not really possible to set it up so that that can work that way. But I wanted to touch on this. The reason for that is because the Deep Roads is filled with adamantine. Adamantine has a radiation. So the race for hundreds of thousands of years has been being filled with this radiation that makes them resistant to magic. So even dark elves that have moved to the surface, it's in their blood. It's been that way for hundreds of thousands of years. You don't just go upstairs and suddenly lose that. All right. So you don't suddenly lose that. So all dark elves, yes, it's a mutation. It's in their blood. It's been that way for so long. You can't get rid of it, you know. It's as natural as their skin color. Okay? It doesn't go away. Just because you moved upstairs. Now, because of the limits that SL gives us, you know, we can't really go on that. But because adamantine is being discovered little by little now, roleplay-wise, I'm going to be using some of that. If you have adamantine weapons or armor or such, it will come into play because there is adamantine in the Deep Roads. That radiation has to come out somehow. But that's just something I wanted to throw out there for all you people who knew about Dark Elves before here. And the darkness ability all dark elves have, that is also in there. That's why the racial ability for dark elves in Ezel is a ball of dark. Oh, actually, that brings me to one other thing. For all of you that are dark elves or know or you want to pass along to the other dark elves, dark elves see also in the ultraviolet spectrum. I'll get back. I love that one. I'll get back to that in a second. Is the ultraviolet vision that they have. Not just night vision, okay? Because night vision allows you to see one color, okay? Typically green. Everything is green, like a cat or a dog or a wolf, okay? Dark elves, they see the regular spectrum of light plus the ultraviolet spectrum, which means they can see things that no one else can see, like butterflies and trolls, okay? They can see patterns that are beyond the spectrum of light that most people can see. Yes, they can do that. If you have a questionable hotel, bring a dark elf with you. They'll make sure. You'll be all right. They will know those things. That's also why they function perfectly in the deep roads. Because, yeah, even though everybody else walks through there and it's pitch black. Yeah, I'll get to the hearing also. Everyone else is pitch black. To them, it's as bright as day. Because that little mushroom over there hanging on the wall, and it's giving out UV, to them, that's like a torch. Okay? As far as vision goes, it's way beyond any wolf. Okay? Wolves have night vision. Okay? That means they see one color spectrum. See, it's either green and black or gray and black. Usually it's green, but you know that's totally up to your whoever's running your thing. But typically that's how it works because they have night vision. They see perfectly day or night regardless, but it's only in one color. Wolves do not see red and all the other colors. Wolves don't see it. Okay? You know, in effect, wolves are colorblind. All right? So if you see a wolf running around wearing purple and green, he doesn't know that. He just thinks it looks cool. Don't give him crap about wearing Joker colors. He doesn't know where that it is. He just thought it was cool looking. Okay? So, that's why, you know, sometimes wolves will have a human or someone else help them pick their clothes. It's like, hey, I'm colorblind. Can you come over here? I don't want them to wear green and red at the same time. I know they don't go together. Okay? I can't tell, but I know they don't because people make fun of me. Can you? Anyway. So, hearing. Yeah, wolves are way beyond elves in that way. And smell, of course. But as far as hearing goes, all elves have the same level of heightened hearing. Dark elves do not have higher hearing than light elves or high elves or anybody else. In fact, wild elves probably have the best hearing if you're talking about elves because they're part animal. Like one of the aquatic elf races is a wild elf, okay, because it's mixed with dolphin. Now, yes, there are aquatic elves, but there's also a wild elf race that's mixed with dolphin. And they have the best hearing of all elves. If you're a drow, you can see in full color regardless. They don't have dark elves. Drow elves do not have dark vision. Wolves have dark vision. Dark elves have ultra vision, which means they see in the regular spectrum of light and the ultraviolet spectrum. Not the same. Okay? But if you're tracking, wolves are far better at that because every color is the same, so they're going to notice a blade of grass that's out of place a whole lot better than anyone else. A wolf ranger is going to be your best ranger. Hands down. Because they'll notice those things. If you only see in two colors, you don't have anything to distract you. Okay? Alright. If someone is radiating ultraviolet light, would Drow see the energy? Oh, yes. Absolutely. Like, any of you familiar with fungoids? They're called myconids. They are mushroom people. Okay? Now, to a dark elf, they glow like daylight. Okay? Everybody else, hey, they look like mushroom people, weird looking things that run around there. Yeah, maybe yummy. All right, if you like mushrooms, which I do, so I'm cool with that. But to a dark elf, most myconids glow like day. Okay? In general, all elves have the same sense of smell, but it can be developed. That's what rangers are for. Regardless, you know, they work on those kind of things. You know, but by their very nature, they're drow are no different than any other elf when it comes to sense of smell or hearing. Their eyes are different, but everything else is the same. Okay. All right, here's another one. The special abilities, since we talked about Loth a few minutes ago, the special abilities that Loth has traditionally given remain the same. Okay, even though it was a different Loth, and her mindset is completely different than everyone else's, the abilities granted are the same. Actually, that brings me up to another point. Drow have an inherent bloodlust. Okay? You know, good and evil is subjective, in my opinion, as far as that goes. But they... So you can't... Yes, they like hurting people. They do. They have a bloodlust. It gives them pleasure to hurt people. But not in where, you know, and also to be hurt. That's why in battle, you know, a dark elf will run around out there laughing while they're cutting people and being cut. You know, they're standing out there, they'd be naked as Argaland there, just bleeding head to toe and laughing. Okay. Now, that doesn't make them psychotic. Okay. That is a natural thing. Just like, you know, wolves feed on creatures. Okay. Cats feed on mice. Okay. Does that make them evil just because they have to eat some? You know, they have this desire to kill that mouse and eat it. not in my opinion. It's natural order. Now, they, just like any sentient being, you can't control your urges. Okay? The control you put on your urges is what makes you part of society. Okay? A social, it is not generally socially acceptable to walk down the street and stab your friend in the back. It's just not done. Whether it's fun or not does not mean it has nothing to do with it. It's socially not acceptable. So they don't do it. Okay? Because it's socially not acceptable. If they want to be part of society, and the more and more that other races become important, the more and more that other races become important, the more that the Dark Elves find the need to be a part, to be an acceptable part of society. So they're not just going, they're going to suppress that and use it on the field of battle. I didn't say that was bad, you know. That is subjective. That is entirely social. So, Dark Elves in general, because of the races that they surround themselves with, have taken that bloodlust and compartmentalized that to battle. Okay? So on the field of battle, they're going to be loving it. Okay? Any Dark Elf worth their salt is going to be at every single battle that OOCLE they can make. Icely, they would be at every battle ever. Okay? But obviously, OOC, you know, hey, real life is a thing. But they have channeled those bloodlust, they have channeled that need to hurt and be hurt into battle. You know, a lot of humans like to play the sadomasochism game, you know, for sex. For a Dark Elf, that's a bad idea. You will never see a Dark Elf play the sadomasochism game for sex because they could not help but go overboard. Their partner would die. No matter how awesome they are, no matter how much control they have, they will kill their partner. And bummer, man. We had this thing set up. I know you had a safe word, but dude, sorry. All right. So they channel that into combat. Okay. That's why it's good to have Dark Elves as an attack force. It's kind of like having undead. See, undead go into battle, they don't feel it. They just keep going until they're dead. Well, Dark Elves are kind of like that, but they do feel it. But they'll keep going until they're dead too. I'm saying that if a drow engages in sadomasochistic activity with their partner, they will kill them. So they stay away from doing that. They will break their toys. That's what happened between Loth and her boy toy. It just got a little bit out of hand. Okay? So you don't play S&M if you're a Dark Elf. Okay? Does that make sense? It's not because I'm the game master and I say you can't do that. That's not reading. That's not why I'm telling you that. I'm telling you that because that's the way Dark Elves are. That's why They crave battle. That's why they crave combat, because that is where they have channeled that energy. Believable fantasy. That's right. Thank you very much for bringing that up. Okay. So you see, you know, just like wolves have to hunt, okay, to feel like they, you know, take down their prey, not just, well, walk into McDonald's and pick up a hamburger. They have to hunt to feel like they ate. That's why when I made that magic oven for Adriana, a wolf feels like they hunted when they go in there and pick up the hamburger from her, or, you know, loaf of bread or whatever it is, you know, because it's still going to taste like meat. No matter what it is, you go in there and buy a strawberry pie. They are going to get the feeling that they hunted a deer, brought it down, and chomped it, and, you know, buy that strawberry pie. Because they need that. They need that. Okay. Dark elves are that same way with combat. They need to be able to hurt someone. It's not that they're, you know, inherently evil in that way. Although many, 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 many races are going to say, hey, you like to hurt people. You're evil. All right. Well, that's cool. You can call me evil. But I know that I keep control over this. Okay. And I use it in battle. I don't just walk around willy-nilly just smacking people upside the head because I can't. It's not how I do things. So, that's just a mentality thing. I know that I have talked forever and a day. And I know, because this is my favorite subject, I sit there and I can talk. I can talk till you all fall asleep. So, questions about all the things that I've talked about. Okay. Okay. If you're half blood, like in your case, you're half drow. If you're half blood, then whatever dominant side you choose as a player is gonna go with you. Like, here's a combo. Because I happen to like wolves and dark elves, I'm going to say, if you are half wolf and half dark elf, that's double trouble, buddy Ro. You got a lot of things to fight against. Your bloodline, you're fighting yourself. My familiar over here, she's a devil. Now, obviously, her alignment, because she's my familiar, is the same as mine. Okay? But, just like I have bloodlust, she also has those same feelings. You're always going to have those feelings. It's what you do with them that separates you from Spot and Frisky and the gerbil you keep in your cage. It's what separates you from them. Yeah, I know who Char is. And actually, Loth would not, the original Loth would not have agreed with that. she felt that the other way around, she felt that Char was her, was hers. And if you know anything about DS relationships, you would understand what that is. The original Char and the original Loth had that relationship. The new Loth has an entirely different relationship with Char. It's a little bit more amiable and not at all sexual. Okay. There's a lot of wolves. Okay. All right. There are a lot of wolves. That's like 6 or 7 different types of wolves. I'm just giving you a general overview. When I talk about wolves, I'm giving you a general overview. Okay. In general, wolves are the best trackers because they only have one kind of vision. Okay. Now, if you're referring to the Enthromai or Enthromai, I can't answer that question exactly because I did not create that race. Okay. You need to talk to that race's creator to find out if they're more human, quote-unquote, or more wolf. He can answer that question. His name is Justinian Diavolo. He will answer that question. But wolves in general have night vision. If they have night vision, then that means they only can see in one color. Okay. Does that answer your question? All right. Okay. Did I miss any questions out there? Yeah. If you're colorblind, then you know that those are the best trackers because they are following the wolf vision, night vision thing. They're going to be better trackers than someone who can see all the colors. That's why for a wolf ranger, kick and tail on that one. Yeah. Did I miss any questions? Or do you have any other questions that I have not answered? Because in 4 minutes, I plan on closing this. No? Okay. Oh, one more thing I wanted to point out. Colors that dark elves wear. Just because you see all the dark elves always running around in black, it's not because we can't wear any other color. Okay? Dark elves that run around in black is because they're blending in to the darkness. Dark elves look awesome in white. There is no restriction. My dress uniform that you sometimes see me in, if you go to dances, my dress uniform is white. Okay? Because we look good in white, right? But we have no restrictions on our colors. Just because I happen to like red and black, especially my blood knights were red and black. It's the color of my house. Okay? That's why I wear red and black. Not because I'm restricted to wearing only white. Yes. Drow look awesome in white. Okay? So, if you see a drow running around in white, never tell them they're wrong. Because they're not. That just means they're showing off. It's like, alright, I look good and I know it. Okay? That's correct. Elstrays, priests, if they wear anything at all, usually they're naked, but if they have to go out in public, they wear white. Okay? Because they want you to see them. Alright? They want you to see them because they know they can kick your tail. They use a silver two-handed sword and wear white. Yes, they wear iron spider silk. Okay? There are not very many iron spiders around anymore. Okay? So if you are lucky enough to get hold of iron spider silk, covet it. Because most of them were killed in the Spider Squid Wars. Only the royal houses, like my own, only the royal houses still have iron spiders. You know. And most of the royal houses are dead. Okay? Because they were the first people that were killed when the Illithids attacked. They went for the biggest guns. Alright. So keep that in mind. No, iron spider silk is not adverse to anyone. And it is, you're wearing cloth that has almost no weight, but has the same armor class as though you were wearing plate mail. Okay? Or though you were wearing chainmail, actually, but you know, it's like that. Okay. Any other questions? Huh. Okay. All right. In that case, I'm going to go ahead and close this. Belados for your attendance. Do pass the words along. Vindas for now.